All right, everybody, all right? I'm back with another video here today. I'm gonna be talking about making the solar generator. Anyway, so I'm gonna put this solar generator together. I'm gonna show you guys how to do it and try to do a step-by-step. I got three cameras going right now. Once again, I am by myself. Derek has gone back to Philly. James is asleep somewhere, being a baby. And it's about, oh, I don't know, 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning probably right now. Actually, we'll call that 1:20 in the morning. We're gonna use this case. We're gonna use this 600 watt, 1200 watt peak, 12 volt DC to 120 volt inverter. And we're gonna use the 12 volt, 20 amp hour Life PO4 battery. Just to kind of give you an idea, there's the battery. There's the inverter. And there'll be a couple of electronics in there. You can see pretty much the main ingredients are already in the box. And now all we gotta do is put in some outlets and then figure out how we're gonna put power in here. You know, and I'll probably just lay the inverter, you know, in some way so I can, you know, do something. I might make it to where this piece pops down and you got some cables in here, or at least for me, like I said, because I'm not gonna sell this version unless you guys specifically request it. It's because I wanna do my own brand, and that's just kinda what I do in the businesses that I run. I make my own brand, sell them to the world, and that's kinda where I get where I am today, so. Kind of how it will be in a sense. And you can see, as I said earlier, I could probably get to 100 amps in here. And just in that array right there, I could get a three battery array in here, no problem. Let's see here, we got one. Yeah, they'd be tight, but I could get three. So that'd be 60 amp hours. I have this whole other side over here where I could lay down, you know, oh geez, I could probably stack these or whatever and not even have to remove this piece and get 20, 40, 60, at least another 80 for sure in here. Or if I just built the battery different, I could just, you know, go to an easy 100 amp hour in this and, you know, it'd be a little bit heavy because these aren't the lightest, but nonetheless, a lot lighter than lead acid batteries would go. So that kind of gives you a general idea of how I'm gonna run this. So now I have very limited room to work with on this box because I don't wanna bring anything through the top of it. I've got a little bit of room on the sides here where I can bring some small things through, possibly down in here, around here, in a corner. As you can see, the size of my pieces, you know, those are gonna be generally a little bit bigger than these little openings I got in the box. So that one could kind of work there maybe, but not all the way without some fabricating. It won't look right there. Same thing there. You know, this at finished product is about 2 3/8 wide. So at 2 3/8, you know, there's not a lot of room on this box. And this is what I wanted to use to charge this so I can use any extension cord. And I am gonna use this because if you look at the back of the box, I can put a lot of things on the back of the box, and that's where we maybe charge from because we've got a lot of room back here where this device here, this piece, this plug would easily fit right in here with no fabrication needed, definitely right up in here with no fabrication needed. It gets a little tighter through here, so it looks like maybe right here. And that brings me into another dilemma, my 30 amp, 120 volt outlet that I'm gonna be using, and this is gonna go into the unit as well. This is going to be an out to go to your RV or whatever. It's 30 amp, 120 volt. A lot of generators have these. And we're going to go ahead and use this and this device. Let's pull this out of the package. Yeah, like look at that. That can go in there no problem. Piece of cake. So we can do a charge, you know, to charge the battery. Come out right there with the 30 amp, no problem. Twist lock. We still got room over here for some stuff. And so that's how we'll run the bigger plugs. Now, this, it came in a little square like this, a little four-way square. And, you know, that's got the 12-volt cigarette lighter, the two USBs, the voltmeter, and the switch. And I can just remove these right out of here. They just spin right off. You can see right here, I can just spin this off and take this piece, should just push right out of here. Yeah, just like so. And I can use these individually in a different strip. I don't really need this template that comes with it. It would be cool in certain other ones or bigger ones, but for this one, I'm probably gonna have to remove these. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to line them up in the front of the box, right across here, right in here by the handle. I could even go into the to this area here if I was going to keep this a sealed unit, but even for me, I could put them up here because I can remove this piece, and even if I didn't remove the piece, I could probably get them in there and then run some really nice wiring you'd never know and see it, and it just come down into here and meet up. So we're gonna run a couple of fuse strips in here so everything's got a fusible link. But let's see what we got here. So I'm gonna pull this piece apart really quick. So yeah, I'm gonna drop those holes right in there really quick with this multi-bit. Three holes right there. Now those aren't centered, but they're centered in the row. But we got one more hole, one small hole for the little switch that we're gonna put in there. There we go. Now, get our switch in. And voila. We have our switch in. And last but not least, we will take, as you can see, got the 12 volt in here, got the switch here, got the voltmeter here, and now I got the USB, and I'll put it right here. Voila, there they are. Step one, I could have moved this over more, but I didn't want to ever hit this with it and end up turning it on or off, so I put it really close. So that's what those are going to look like, just like that, guys. You can see them in that shot right there. And as you can see, this is all three of them. USB, voltmeter, 12 volt cigarette lighter, and the switch. And then once I get those all wired up, those would be awesome. I'll get them straight in there. And that is the start of our solar generator, people. That is going to give us our 12 volt system for 12 volt cigarette lighter adapter, USB, 1 amp, 2.1 amp, and from here we'll jump into the 120 volt system when we start putting the inverter in. And yeah, so anyways, if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Give me a like on this. If there's anything you want to see me do with these, as usual, please put that in the comment section down below. I'll put a link to the website where you can get this in the comment section down below. And as always, man, stay cool, and we'll see you. Keep checking back. I'm going to be doing a bunch of these. Remember, there's a three-part series on, well, there's three different sizes of these, so you want to be sure to get the video on each one of these, the small, the medium, the large, and then as the whole unit goes together, when you put all three of these units together, they are going to straight up rock and roll, I assure you. Anyways, man, I'm Wes. Till next time, we'll see you.